Howdy, y'all. Joe Hills here, recording as I always do in Nashville, Tennessee. And today on the Working Draft server, I'm joined by the illustrious Dr. Redstone, PhD. What exactly is your PhD in?
It is in the Redstone Sciences.
So you are Dr. Redstone, Doctor of the Redstone Sciences. Your middle name doesn't happen to be Science, because that would really kind of throw everything for a loop, wouldn't it?
It would, but unfortunately it is not Science, so...
Fair enough, Dr. Not Science Redstone. Okay, so today, as you can see, I've made some changes to my base. I kind of wanted to start experimenting with the technology before I tried to lay it out properly. And there's all sorts of pieces of technology in here that are incredibly terribly laid out. I started doing this on a live stream. If you guys aren't following me, twitch.tv/JoeHills. Anyway, so you see these coke ovens here, Doc?
Yes.
Okay, so you know they create creosote oil as a byproduct.
That is correct.
So I decided, okay, well, I'll make a tank to put the creosote oil in, right? That's easy enough. So, you know, I get some waterproof pipes, pump the creosote oil out from both coke kilns into that tank. And the tank is pretty simple. To make a tank wall, you just need like 4 iron plates or whatever, and it makes 4 tank wall blocks. You construct a frame, you throw some glass in here, you throw in some valves. You can see like a valve piece right down here.
Okay.
And so pipes will only connect to the valve pieces, so you don't have to worry about your pipes connecting all over the place. Valves on the top are input, you know, so here's my top. So you see the valve on the pipe there? That's a creosote oil input. And down here, this would be an output if I had somewhere to put the creosote oil.
Okay.
Which I don't, because I don't know yet what I'm going to do with it. Now, you can do a few neat things with creosote oil. One of them is you can make wooden posts, which seem a lot like fences at first, except they are actually more like telephone poles. So check this out. So you see how it doesn't do the ribbon on the it doesn't have that extra fence post bar there on either end? Yeah, so you can make telephone poles with it. If you have wire and you put the wire on top, actually let me get more than one piece of wire here. If you put wire on top of it, it'll actually create a little ridge there. I don't know if you can see that. But you see how it's got that little bump on the one side and it doesn't on the other? Yeah. So anyway, creosote oil. This is about all you can do with it unless you're making rail lines. You can make railroads and you can make power lines. Anything with lines is good, but this is a block game, not a line game. You know, we're not over here with our mirrors and our credit cards. So anyway, I've been thinking like, well, what could I do with the creosote oil? And I found out that one additional use of it is you can run it into a steam boiler. And the steam boiler is pretty simple. There's two types. There's two classes. There's two types of classes. There's high pressure and low pressure, and there's liquid fueled and solid fueled. And you can combine those in any order. So you could have like a liquid fueled high pressure or low pressure boiler. Sorry if that's a lot at once. So this is a solid fueled steam boiler here. And what you can do is you can put, if I put like some sticks in here, it'll start burning, and that does like nothing. That barely elevates the temperature. I'd have to put coal coke in here to really kind of get it going. I'm just going to put one in, and the temperature you can see starts rising. It's at 21 Celsius right now, now 22. You see that second bar there?
Yes.
Yeah. So when it hits 100 degrees Celsius, what do you think happens?
Nothing.
Okay. What's in the bar? What's in that blue bar over there with the red lines on it?
Water.
Okay, and we got a temperature meter over here that we're trying to get to hit 100 degrees Celsius.
Oh, I thought it was 212.
That's Fahrenheit.
Oh, right.
Celsius is a scale used for something else.
I forget. I'm here in the U.S., and so the Celsius is very foreign.
See, obviously, living in continental Europe myself, the location of Tennessee and Nashville.
Exactly.
I'm much more worldly.
Continent. It's definitely a different continent.
Yes. So anyway, as you can see, it takes a lot of coal coke just to raise this from like 20 degrees to like 37 now. 20 degrees is like room temperature, I think. So it doesn't go all the way down to zero because that would be colder than the ambient air.
Yes.
You'd need a heat pump to do that, and we don't have those. So, anyway, I'm going to take the extra cold coke out so I don't waste it. But once this actually gets to 100, it starts making steam. And then the steam runs out through all of these pipes to steam engines. I've got commercial steam engines, and I've got one industrial steam engine. The commercial steam engines max out at 4 MJ per tick. Okay. And the industrial maxes out at 8 MJ per tick. But they need to be supplied with a constant supply of steam.
Okay.
Now, one of the problems with them, obviously, is that you have to run steam to them.
Yes.
Yes. Lots of steam has to run to them. And
hence your very modern art-looking base.
Yes. This is terrible. Every part about this is terrible, and I'm actually about to tear it down. This is about to be replaced, is one of the goals of this episode. So one thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here. So are you familiar with the Roland machine at all?
Yes, I am.
So if I come over here to my Roland machine, I don't know if it has a shared inventory that you can see on SMP.
I can see, yes.
So I can make iron plates with that. And
oh, I can't see the output, but I can see what you input.
Yeah, well, it's going to take. It's got an arrow going across. So now I got iron plates out.
All right.
Okay. So with those 8 iron plates, if we come over here to an auto crafting table, this first one here, you'll see, because this is SMP friendly, that I can put 4 of those together to get a tank wall. And what I actually want to do is I want to make a tank that I can store my surplus steam in, so I don't have to have that boiler running all the time. And I'm realizing, okay, I need iron bars in order to make the tank valve.
Okay.
Let me pull that up in my nearly enough items. Valve. Okay, so that's 4 iron bars in the corners. So you can now see me starting to drop in those iron bars here. Whoa.
That is correct.
And I'm terrible at everything. And I put in some levers here.
Oh, cool.
And so now the thing about this is I can have a bunch of iron tank valves or whatever that if I have a tank full of steam, I can use these valves to run steam out of that tank and into those engines, and possibly not in this terrible an order. So I bet you're wondering, well, Joe, where are you going to put that tank?
Yes, that is a very valid question.
So come on down here.
Okay.
And this is where I'm going to put the steam.
That is a large tank.
It is a 7x7 tank, which is the largest base you can have. It took all of my iron to make this, which is why I was asking, like, oh, hey, you don't happen to have any excess iron over there, would you? Because that'd be really handy. Now, the thing about it is valves need to be, okay, so the frame of it, essentially these sides here, like this, like the very outermost pieces, have to be made of the tank wall material. But anything inside of that, like the 5x5 within the frame, can be a combination of tank walls, tank gauges, which is this glass. It's like Golf Alpha Uniform Golf Echo. And then tank valves. And, of course, I'm using a bad pick on this. So, like, for example, I probably want to actually have enough gauges that I can output steam for all the engines I'll ever want, right?
Right.
Now, one thing that I can do as well is if I have a if I have a valve on the bottom of my tank here, I can actually build a second tank underneath this with a valve on the top in the same place. You see how that's,
yes,
you know, the same there? So I could actually fill a second tank off of this one and make it double height if I had that much iron.
So in essence, you could have a 7x7 on top of a 7x7 and have enormous amounts of steam.
Yes. And so my plan is to just kind of use this. Eventually, we're going to have all these energy conduits running out of Energy Mountain. But let's say that I want to run some sort of machines that are just unfairly energy consumption requiring. Like, if I wanted to do something that would, like, blow out the grid, I should augment that with my own power generation.
That does make sense.
And so what I'm doing essentially here is I'm creating a system by which I can achieve such augmentation. So I'm just going to go ahead and put a little, checks symbol in here. Worth of these valves. And then if we step out here and I place 2 more blocks, then this will actually turn into a single device.
Oh, wow.
So you see how the gauge is now fully formed?
Yes.
and the gauge walls all around are now like connected, essentially.
And the glass connected its textures.
Yeah, now it's one object. So if you right-click on it, you'll see that it has a capacity of 5,488 volume.
That is quite large.
That's a lot of volume. now, the storage capacity we currently have for Steam and Energy Mountain is 4 million.
Oh, wow.
So I'm kind of outdoing Energy Mountain. I didn't realize how phallic some of these windows might end up looking. That was not intentional. so anyway, what I'm planning on doing is running pipes out from these sides here. And I've got them at diagonals to each other so the pipes don't connect to each other. And so then I'll run them into this wall and up and then have like engines built into the wall here that then pump into energy conduits. But for right now, what we would really need to get going on is providing this with an actual, you know, source of steam, right?
Right.
So, to that end, let's see. I'm kind of thinking, well, what's actually the best way to do this here? I could start using the existing low-power steam boiler, or low-pressure steam boiler, or I could make an awesome new one that's way bigger and more powerful. And I'm kind of inclined toward making a ludicrously larger one. But, you know, that's just kind of, that's my style. You don't happen to have a pick or anything for digging on you, do you?
I just broke it.
Let me toss you here. Go ahead and take this stone pick here.
Okay, sweet.
And what we're going to do is we're going to dig out a little bit of this wall here. Don't dig up because you might break into the tank. Although, I guess with your with the stone pick, you're not going to do too much damage.
Yes.
Either way. So what I was going to do is I'm thinking I'm going to dig out an area here for my new steam boiler. And let's see. I probably should bring some sort... you don't have any torches on you by any chance.
I have absolutely nothing. I came horribly prepared.
Well, no, that's completely acceptable. I shouldn't expect you to come over here and do everything for me.
Normally I keep quite a few resources on me just in case of situations like this.
No, but... it's fine. I just grabbed another two torches out from about... and a third? Awesome. So let's see. If we keep digging over, we might actually... Where are we in the mountain? Okay, so we're underneath the creosote oil tank right now, which is a fine place to be. Let's see, this is 73.
Now, you said you could run creosote oil into the liquid boiler?
And yeah.
Does it act as a fuel then?
Yes.
Okay.
The liquid boiler is a lot more expensive, but it runs on fuel, biofuel, or creosote oil.
Okay.
And, you know, let's see, fuel you would get by refining oil. You might have seen like the oil refineries,
yes.
Items. I don't know if we've actually made any of those on the server yet, but I've got a massive oil well over in my, wilderness area I've claimed. And so what I would actually be able to do is to, what would you call it? To refine said oil. To harvest and refine said oil, and then send it through carts with those, what do you call those portals? The Mistcraft portals?
Yes.
So using the Mistcraft portals, I could send oil from there in a cart tank over to here to fill a normal tank. Because, like, these iron tanks here can be filled using carts, because this is all part of Railcraft.
Yes, indeed.
Which is awesome. Okay, so I'm thinking that I probably don't need the absolute massivest area here, but what I will need, is to keep an eye on where I'm going to fall into pits. Okay, so in order to keep the boiler from blowing up, you have to provide it with water continuously. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up down in this little 3x3 area. I'm going to grab two buckets of water real quick, and move an aqueous accumulator over there. Are you familiar with the aqueous accumulator, Dr. Redstone Mister?
I have heard of it, only in studies.
Okay, well, if you might have read some studies about how excellent it is at removing water without, or I should say, transporting water without removing the source. Now, a normal pump in the game would actually remove the water itself. It, like, would keep track of the volume of water. Whereas the aqueous accumulator transmits water without destroying the source of it.
Okay.
So that way I don't have to worry about this running out on me.
Exactly.
Which is really bad because the boiler, is going to actually require that I provide it with continuous water or it will blow up. If it's hot and does not have water, boom. Bye-bye. That's it. That's the end of it.
That doesn't sound pleasant.
No, it's not. Okay, so I have a second aqueous accumulator set up. Okay, so I'm going to start knocking out some of this pipe in because, well, for one thing, I'm going to need it anyway. So I should also make sure that there's no heat left in this boiler because I'm about to... Yeah, okay, good. It's back to room temperature.
Now, is this all diamond pipe? No. Is this all gold pipe?
This is all gold waterproof pipe. You mix cooked cactus with gold
pipe. That
is
expensive piping.
Yes. This is why I don't have any gold for, any other project right now. Not
yes.
that you asked or had any concern about that, really. Now, the aqueous accumulator, like many of the other thermal expansion objects, you have to use the good wrench to remove it, I think. There's, a thermal... Wait, is that not right? Why is this not removing?
No, I think you can just break it normally. Oh, no, you have to shift right-click with the wrench.
Oh, you are truly a scholar. And goodness gracious alive, what a difference that made. So I'm stuck in my pipe, and this is the worst part. Every part of my base is ruined, essentially, until I get this fixed. I cannot wait to get all these pipes out of here. They are constantly a threat to my sanity. So I can just hop on down here. The aqueous accumulator is smart enough to know... Oh, whoops, went too far. The aqueous accumulator is smart enough to know not to... It knows that you're going to be piping out of it. It doesn't need a... what do you call that? Wooden transport pipe or what? Yeah. So it'll just start... As soon as the aqueous accumulator itself fills up, this gold pipe should then start filling up.
Okay.
Which I think I don't even need. I think... Or wait, maybe not. Oh, because that's not a waterproof one. Let me put in a gold waterproof pipe here. Shift click. So you see how that just
there
fills up?
There we go. Okay.
Awesome.
Wow.
Now, it'll output automatically in whatever directions you want it to. And right now I want it to output to the top. I'm going to put a firebox directly atop it. And if you... Whoa, that was not how I wanted to do that. I was going to say, if you click on that, you'll see that the firebox should be receiving water. Oh, wait, maybe it's not going to until I add tanks. Okay, so we're going to add some boiler tanks on top of the firebox. And then we will see if it's actually receiving water. And if not, we'll move the whole thing up.
Okay.
So I've got several high-pressure boiler pieces. I hope that I have room to remove one more layer here. Awesome, I do. So here we go. Okay, yeah, we are just underneath my coke kilns. So my floor of my base is going to be a little bit messed up for a while, but I'll fix it later. Okay.
Now, I assume when these are all placed, they will all join together, similar to the tank fashion.
Yes. So you see how it's now one piece?
Gotcha.
Whoa, and that was not the piece that... You put a, it knows that it's supposed to do something different when it's connected to that. Okay, so now you see how we got water coming in, and we got 108,000 water is the capacity. Now, I want to let this thing fill up entirely just to be sure that I'm not going to run into any issues. And the first time I actually get the thing heated up, I'm going to want to verify that the single aqueous accumulator is keeping up. I believe it should, but I have not experimented with that personally. And much like the nuclear reactor, I like to, directly observe in my version of the game that I'm running that whatever I'm doing is not going to blow everything up.
That's a very good idea, especially since this is, in the basement of your home.
Yeah, so
explosions aren't friendly.
No, they're terrible. So, I'll probably babysit this while I edit or do something else for a little while. So we've got it filling up with water. While it does that, we're also going to want to start adding fuel. Now, you said you don't really have much coal. The amount of coke I have is enough to maybe get this up to, 30 degrees.
Okay.
So, do we want to go on... Do we have some sort of... Do we want to go grab a bunch of trees, maybe? Just a bunch of logs from Jade's place? Do you have your jetpack?
I fell into lava earlier.
Oh, here. I've got an extra one.
Sweet.
I fell into lava, and I made an extra jetpack. Let me charge it for you. So I had to make an extra jetpack to get back to where I thought I died, and I was concerned I had lost it entirely, but luckily it had like popped away, in the death explosion of items.
Yes, I fell into a lava pocket looking for my mining turtle, and
Is it possible to just obsidianize that and then break out the turtle later, or would that be a terrible
way to go about it? That's
what
I was doing, and I thought I had gotten rid of all the lava, and so of course I stood on top of the block that I was breaking, and I wasn't wearing my jetpack because I wanted a lap pack, and just went downhill from there.
I am sorry to hear of your great misfortune, my friend. That is indeed a woeful tale.
It is. It was very sad. It was a sad day.
Okay, so this is now two-thirds filled, and we can fill it up the rest of the way once we get back, because we're going to have more stuff to do. But
wonderful.
Yeah, I figure we'll just nip on over to Jade's real quick and grab a whole bunch of trees or logs out of her little tree farm export thing. I've got to say, I'm really glad to have somebody on the server who knows all this buildcraft stuff, because this is all Greek to me.
I just did lots of research, so... Oh, whoa. What did you have happening over here with the wheat farm?
What do you mean?
There's, like, tracks and rails, and there's a creeper behind you.
Whoa. Yeah, that's some sort of thresher, I think. I think it harvests when the... it harvests the crops or something.
Oh, wow.
But it's, like... Oh. Careful with the creeper. They're targeting me, both of them, apparently, now.
Oh, now there's two of them.
Yeah.
And I don't even think those are the two I tried to kill. Oh.
Well, one less problem.
Yeah.
Okay. But yeah, so that way you don't have to have that weird square shape. Like, you see how on the Infernal Farm up here, she's got to have it shaped so that the it's like radial around the machines.
Yes.
Yeah. So it's just way more space efficient.
And this does carrots and potatoes as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it'll just harvest any sort of food, I think.
Wow.
So I'm just gonna come down into the house here and look for. She's probably got a log full of What do you call it? Barrel full of logs somewhere.
Can we use planks too? Because there's a bunch of planks out here. I don't know if they burn any quicker or not.
Oh, I mean, it's one of those things like we will need like stacks on stacks.
Okay. Oh, they burn the same barrel planks and logs do. And here we have
the logs barrel. We can make into charcoal first.
Oh, I understand your point now.
Okay. Yeah, I see a bunch, 23 stacks of planks here. But did you find logs somewhere or no?
I did find a stack and... No, two stacks of logs here.
Okay.
Here, I'll toss them to you here.
Okay, awesome. And if you want to just grab... how many spaces do you have in your inventory? Do you just want to grab...
It's pretty empty.
Okay, grab like 15 stacks of planks. I'm not even joking. Take half of what's... No, it's right in here.
Oh, okay. I was going to take over here because this one has 62 stacks of 64. So.
Yeah, whichever. It'll all burn.
I always try to take what...
Well, in that case, just fill your inventory. Like, literally, we're going to have to make several trips. This is a huge... heating one of these things up to 100 Celsius is going to be a huge process. So, you ready to go?
All right, yes. I have almost a full inventory.
Awesome. We are off to the races with... The races in this case not really having much to do with the derbies, but I mean there's some steam, there's some pressure. It's very exciting. People are gonna loudly shout out things about, you know, who's ahead of who. Joe's ahead of DocRedstone right now. Woo, and he wins. Well, that was anticlimactic. Everybody knew that was gonna happen. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and throw half of these logs into each coke oven to start cooking them. Although that's like the slowest way ever to cook them, isn't it? I should probably just use my IC2 furnace thing.
Now, if we want to go, I know it's kind of a long trip. We probably should have done it from Jade's. But if we head back to my base, I have an induction furnace, which will cook those things into charcoal in no time.
Oh, well, I mean, we're going to start feeding it. Let's see. Dang it, I went down one too many layers. I'm going to have to poke another hole in the floor over here so I can easily come up. Oh, I'm also going to need to run pipes out, I knew I was going to need to run pipes out. So, let's see. One set of pipes is going to come out from over here.
Now, do you have to use an engine to pump the steam out of the boiler, or does it just come out when it's ready?
It'll come out when it's ready.
Okay.
So, I'm just kind of setting up two sets. I don't want these to touch each other. Okay, so that'll start pumping out some there. Then I probably am actually going to want to do another set above it and try not to bust that coke engine. Not that it matters a ton, but, you know, whatever. Oh, yeah. Also, lighting all this down here might be important later. So we're just going to kind of do the same over here where we come up and over. Okay, so if you want to, while I start digging this out, you can actually start throwing in those stacks of planks.
Okay.
And so you see it'll pull from these sidebar things here, and we are currently up to 21 Celsius, and we've burned through a ton of this. Like, it
man.
Is...
oh, man. It just eats this.
Oh, yeah. It like that's why I was saying, like, we really are going to want to have the good stuff for this. Okay, so I'm realizing that these are going to hook up to the creosote oil tanks up there, which is less than ideal. So what I'm probably going to do is... Oh, no, that's not going to work either. Well, if they intersect, it's not a huge problem as long as I have separate conduits. It gets kind of slower than I'd like. Well, whatever. So, fine.
Now you could alternate the pipes. I know gold, I think, is even quicker.
Gold is the fastest, is the thing. And it's not really going to matter until we hit 100. So let me grab that charcoal and throw in the next stack of logs. Also, I mean, if you look at how much gold piping I have up here, this is all going to go.
Like, okay.
Well, all the gold piping up from up here is intended to move down there. So okay. It's not like I have any manner of shortage.
Gotcha.
Let's see. But yeah, what I'd like to do is eventually set up that creosote oil tank to feed a second liquid boiler. So that would not be... So having those kilns there is not necessarily a huge problem. But I do have to be wary of them for the time being, because connecting pipes to the wrong pipes is just always a bad thing in this.
It is.
So, I don't know. What are your observations so far, Doctor?
My observations are that this is a little bit above my pay grade.
I was going to say, you have a PhD, and this is above your pay grade. This does not bode well for me.
This is pretty cool. I do, you know, I've been trying to mess with thermal expansion and stuff other than just IC2 stuff for power-wise, and it's definitely really cool what you can do with, you know, boilers and this and that and the other. It's definitely interesting.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to never coming down here again once this is once this is kind of more together. Not that it's, you know... Well, not that it'll ever be truly done, especially if I have to feed things into this, but once I can set up, you know, a fuel cart to deliver fuel over and stuff like that, it'll be nice to change of pace. So it seems like we're keeping up water-wise, and we're up to 43 degrees Celsius. Once we hit 100...
And it only took about 13 stacks of logs to do.
Oh, I know. It's pretty terrible. I'm just going to put that in there for right now, and... So... It'll eventually pull from the charcoal. That's what was cooked so far. And, okay, so what I'm going to want to do, too, I'm going to want to start figuring out exactly how I'm going to want to run my engine pipes back up. Because, like, if that thing is fully fed for right now, you can spare a minute to pop up here, and I can kind of show you what I'm thinking.
Okay.
So... essentially, what I would want to do is run those pipes up this back wall here, essentially.
Okay.
To, like, this is the edge of my area. So I can't build past here. But I would essentially just dig down and run the pipes through this area and straight up into engines that would then power the, build craft power or what have you.
Okay, cool.
So, let's see if I'm at the right height. Yeah, so right... Wow, that was literally perfect.
Wow.
That was just a guess. But yeah, so you see I would essentially have a bunch of conduits running up through there.
Okay.
And what I'd probably do is I'd offset them by one. So, for example, this linkage would be like this, and then this linkage over here would go like that. So, and this one would run directly along the floor, whereas that one would run, you know, one up and kind of keeping them offset from each other. Supposedly, we're going to have new liquid conduits in the update this weekend. So that might make this even easier. But either way, I've got a ton of this extra gold stuff.
All right.
So we can just.
Now, what do these new conduits entail?
They're essentially like the energy conduits, but for fluids.
Oh, okay, wow.
Okay, wow. So as you can see, we are now out of fuel.
Did it really eat that?
It really ate all of that. So if you want to throw the extra planks in. The thing is, once you get it to a temperature, it stays at that temperature for a long time because it's got because the specific heat of it keeps it going at whatever it's at. So it's not going to drop back down immediately if it runs out of fuel, but it will start dropping, you know, over time.
Man, I haven't seen anything eat through coke coal like that.
Oh, yeah, it is ludicrous. And you know how long it takes to get coke coal.
I know. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. That's a lot. I mean, that stuff burns in a generator for at least 2 minutes, and here it's 10 seconds, maybe.
Yeah, now the thing is, though, once I get this to 100 degrees, it'll start producing steam. Now, the higher it gets to its actual maximum operating temperature, the less fuel it will require to maintain that temperature.
Oh, okay. Well, that's not as bad.
So there's an efficiency gain to actually keeping it fueled to the maximum temperature, but it'll be producing steam at any temperature above 100 Celsius. So we'll actually start filling this tank might actually end up filled before we are able to bring this up to maximum temperature.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And then at that point, we don't have to worry about it so much.
And now this can't overheat unless you run out of water. Correct?
Correct. But okay. That's why you really want to make sure you're getting that water in there, because if you're not,
yes,
it'll blow. It is literally a pressurized gas machine, or pressure. Okay. So enjoy, you know?
Yes. All right.
But yeah, you can see that it's the continuous fuel supply is, you know, heating it up over time.
Yes.
So let's see here. Where was that little... here it is. Got my little conduit way over here is where it's going to be, ultimately, or one of them. And I'm just going to... I've got a whole bunch of these... Okay, so there's two types... there's like three or four types of these steam engines. The cheapest one actually has a boiler built into it, if you wanted to come take a look at that.
I seem to have lost you. Are you upstairs?
I'm back upstairs, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
There we go. All right.
And I'm... Yeah, so... I'm back up in my base. I was going to show you the different types of engines, one of the interesting ones. See this, like, brassy one here, this hobbyist steam engine?
Oh, wow.
That has water in it, you see, as well as the steam gauge. This looks a lot like the boiler itself, right?
Yes.
And the reason is this is essentially a self-contained boiler and engine. So if you just wanted to play around with the fundamentals of this, you could using this machine here.
Okay, so you just toss some power in there and it...
You run some water, it'll blow up if you don't supply it with water. It's the same basic concept.
Okay, cool. And does it take nearly as long to heat up?
No. Because essentially the bigger the boiler is, the more it takes to heat up. Like I made a 3x3x3 boiler tank, but you can make them much smaller. You can have a 1x1 boiler tank that'll heat up super quickly. And I've dropped way too far down. I keep forgetting that the boiler is not on the same floor as the tank because I've been coming back and forth to this tank for like, hours to get all this iron in place.
Yes.
So, yeah, we are at 88 degrees Celsius, 89 now. And I think this will go up to about 1,000.
Oh, wow.
Just if you look at it, like that blue bar there, that's at 10% essentially.
Okay. Oh, that coke coal's not, well, maybe not. I spoke too soon.
We're going to need the planks and the other stuff, too, believe me. But, yeah, getting this up to full, I think, would take about 4 stacks of coke coal.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, it is a non-trivial exercise, I will tell you that.
So in about 7 degrees Celsius, it should start producing steam.
Yeah, and then once the steam gets above halfway on that gauge there, it'll start overflowing naturally into the pipes.
Okay, cool.
Without the need of a pump or anything. But so that first 430,000. So essentially, okay, this thing has a capacity of about, let's see, about a sixth of the tank, I guess. See, yeah, eight times. Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
So, wow. It's gonna take some time, but once it hits that 100 though, it'll just start producing steam like no tomorrow.
Up, and we're there. 100 degrees.
And so there you see it's producing 4,000 steam a second, or well, it's like 4,000 every time it increments, but I'm not sure how quickly that's incrementing. And that might be every half second it's producing 4,000 steam.
Oh, where do you see that number where it tells you about how much steam?
I'm hovering over the steam thing on the far left.
Oh, mine wasn't updating.
Might have to, yeah.
Yeah, I closed it and opened it and saw it was filling up.
But yeah, so once it hits that halfway gauge, it's going to start like essentially staying about level.
Okay.
So now you see these steam pipes over here are beginning to fill with steam.
Oh, very good. Wow, those gold pipes, when you say they're quick, like you expect quick, but this is...
So now our tank is filling up super quick over here, too. We're already at 30,000, which is not, you know, nothing.
Yeah.
Now, I'm actually generating steam more quickly than this is able to pump it out. So what I probably want to do is grab me some extra gold pipage and start setting up extra connectors, because any excess steam that's just sitting in the boiler is going to be wasted here.
Yes.
So we are just going to... grab that extra prop there. And, whoops. Of course, I'm doing this incredibly poorly in every way, shape, and or form. So, let's see. What's the optimal way to bring this one over? Let's see. Actually, it might be to bring it along down here. So, it's okay if they touch each other as long as you have a separate output for every... a separate input for every output. Dang it. Those loops, though, can create lag in it. So you really don't want to have too many actual, like, circles.
Okay.
But it's okay to have... So essentially, you see this pipe is going to get saturated by the fact that it has two inputs, even though it has two outputs. Okay, you see this junction right here? This junction right here isn't going to slow it down because... it's got the same number of outputs as inputs, if that makes any sense. We're not using that as a junction. It just happens to touch there, and that's not a problem.
Okay, wonderful.
So, let's see. And then I'm going to want one more, which, wow, I'm just burning through this pipe. It is very, very easy to run out of this, apparently.
I am out of wood as well, and there's about 3 stacks in there before it runs out.
Okay, so. Well, let me. What's the temperature at?
I think it was 115.
Okay.
125, excuse me.
Cool. I'm going to throw the rest of the logs in the furnace here and bring down some of the charcoal. But as you can see, I mean, we're wasting steam right now with the amount that's, if it's maxed out like that, that is us, like, not fully offloading it as effectively as we might. Well, sorry, you're kind of in my way. I'm hoping that I didn't need more valves on the top here. I didn't really think about that. Oh, I'm out again? It's like, man, how many of these am I going to need?
Oh, it's pulling it out pretty decently now. It's actually not reaching its maximum. It's pulling it out quicker than it can.
Okay, cool. Oh, I'm going to need to dig you out. And there's my pick. 1 second.
There we go. I got it. I had the wooden pick you gave me.
Okay, great. Yeah.
Or stone pick you gave me.
But yeah, so as you can see, though, it is at 135. This is not even the maximum fuel efficiency, as I said. But wow. Yeah.
It hits 862 and then goes up to 863 and back down to 862.
Yeah, I think that's just, that's still not, we're not maxing out. We're not saturating it.
Yeah, no, I was supporting your hypothesis.
Yeah, I would have put more inputs on the top of the tank here if I would have known that was going to be an issue. But yeah, as you can see, we've already got 500,000 steam in the tank.
Wow.
And I mean, that can power engines for a good while.
All right. You only have 4 charcoal, 3 charcoal, 2 charcoal, 1 charcoal.
So, you know, like I said, it's got a high specific heat, so you can wait and see how long it takes for it to start dropping. But that 30 is not nothing, that extra 31 degrees or whatever it was at.
Okay. Yeah, it hasn't dropped yet, so.
Yeah, let me... I'm really disappointed that that I'm wasting steam by not pumping it out quicker. Hmm. Oh, well. Toss in some... Has it dropped 1 degree yet?
Let's see here. No, it's still 141, and that's where it was when you went to get some more fuel, so...
Yeah, so as you can see...
Now it's dropped 140. Degree.
Okay, I just wanted to see roughly how long it took to drop 1 degree before I put some more fuel in there.
Yeah.
But yeah, and that's going to all vary depending on how big the boiler is, whether it's high pressure or low pressure, all that sort of stuff.
Gotcha.
So, awesome. Well, do you have any other questions about any of this? Because I think that we've pretty much covered... on the plus side, I've consolidated my incredible snaky mess from, you know, just being all over the place up here. Like, look at how much easier this is to walk around in now.
Look, we can navigate.
I know. And then once I pull out all these engines and move them against the wall over here and stuff, it'll be even better. So.
Wow.
I'm excited.
That's really cool. That'll be awesome when that's finished.
Yeah, I'm going to
have to
remember.
Keep stopping by.
Oh, yeah, certainly. You're always welcome to check on my progress and visit and hang out. So, anyway, do you want to do your outro or should I go ahead and do mine?
You go ahead since you did the intro.
Alrighty. Until next time, y'all, this is Joe Hills from Nashville, Tennessee, joined by Doc Redstone. Not Dr. Science Redstone, Doctor of the Redstone Sciences, but Doc Redstone, Doctor of the Redstone Sciences. Any final words, Doc Redstone?
Thanks, everybody, for watching. Peace out.
Until next time, y'all, keep adventuring.
Okay.
One last thing that we forgot to do, I forgot to come down here and show you the glass walls of the tanks actually filling up. You see these gauge walls here?
Yes.
They are actually filling this with steam. Now, unfortunately, the tank code treats all liquids as gravity. You know, they don't expand to fill the volume of their container. So essentially, this is liquid steam now. It's no longer gas steam. But you can see those 5 inputs of, like, liquid steam being poured in here.
It looks really cool.
And the tank level just rose a little bit. I don't know if you caught that.
Yeah, it's kind of like basing each of these pieces of glass almost like if you were looking at the monitor inside the tank.
Mm-hmm.
That's really cool.
Yeah, I always thought the tank stuff was pretty cool, which is yet another reason I wanted to implement it. But also just watching the liquid pour in is just so funny, I think.
It is. It's kind of...
Because it's steam. That's not really how steam works. But...
Yeah, it should be floating to the top and definitely not just... like pipe in. Yeah
So anyway,
you're gonna have to show me about these tanks because I have my lava system in my base and I'd love to store that.
Oh yeah, this is the perfect way to store lava.
Yeah, that'd be a lot of lava too.
Do you just need a lot of iron.
All right, well I have to get working on that because I just spent all my iron on a bunch of various circuits.
Yeah, that's very fair. Well, anyway, for a second time, this is a postscript. Keep adventuring.